Welcome to a new episode of my series From Zero to AlgoTrader, a series where I start from scratch and build my own AlgoTrading framework. At the moment, I'm developing a charting software to visualize data, but there is one problem, which let's say makes it currently not very user-friendly. And in this episode, I'm finally gonna fix it. So let me explain. A charting software requires data. That's pretty obvious. And this data is provided by my database. But how is the data inserted into the database and where do I get the actual data from? Where I get the data from, I will answer later in the video. Let's for now focus on the first question. Currently, there are two ways to write data into the database. You could either use a database administration tool, like pgAdmin for example, since I'm using a PostgreSQL database, and insert the data by hand, which honestly would be ridiculous, or you could import it as a CSV file. But this requires that you are using additional software, and the user is working directly on the database, which is prone for errors like importing data for the wrong symbol. The second option, which I used until now, is to write a small script that inserts the data into the database. This has the advantage that you can bulk insert multiple files at once, for example by defining an import folder. But this is also not a very user-friendly experience. You have to go through the directories, find the right folder, have proper file namings, and the user has to manually execute a script. With my new solution, I want to tackle all these problems. And here is how I'm gonna do it. I'm implementing a CSV upload feature for the front end. This way the user can first select a symbol which he wants to upload new data for and then just add the file via drag and drop. The front end can directly do some validations, for example for the file structure, and the backend service imports the new data into the database. No more file naming, no additional software required, and no execution of some random script. But the backend service I mentioned does not exist yet. So I'm going to build this as well in this episode. But why am I building another new service for this? Let me explain this by showing you my current architecture and then a tiny sneak peek of my newly designed architecture. So currently I need to access the database from two different points. The first one is from the front end. This fetches the data from a web server through a REST API. And the second one is from the backtester, which obviously also needs data and therefore accesses the database as well. The backtester also calculates the indicators which rely on the data as well, but this will be extracted in the future, so this is for another episode. So the problem in general is that I'm accessing the database from multiple points which are defining the same queries, resulting in redundancies and all in all bad maintainability. And the solution is a separate database accessor API. Then whenever I need to access the database, I can do so from this one single service. But I think I talked enough. Let's now finally build this new API. Hey, 8-hour flight, we just landed in Sorrento. Yeah. Came a long way from smoking Nicks and rocking Echo. Sprinted to the telly, copped a room. So the first version of the API is ready and I decided to write it in Python and I used Fast API for the first time. And I noticed this automatically generates some documentation, so let's check this out first. So the service is running on port 8000 and when accessing the docs route, you get this documentation UI. Here you can see I have mainly implemented three get routes, to get all the markets, to get a specific market, and of course to get all the candles of a specific symbol. Then there are two post routes, to insert a new market, and to insert candles into the database. And there are two delete routes, to either remove all the candles together with the market information, or to remove just the candles. In the documentation, you can even test the routes and send real REST requests to the API. So if we try out the get markets route, you can see here we get as a response all the markets that are currently in the database. Now it's time to replace the old API with the new one, and to make use of the new endpoint to insert new candles into the database, I'm also implementing the new CSV upload feature. Alright, all the new endpoints are now implemented. And when I open the symbol search, you can see that I have implemented this three-dot icon for every symbol in the list. Clicking this opens a drop-down menu, And here you have a remove option and an upload option. The remove option opens a new model and gives you the option to remove either just the candles or the candles with also the market information. And if I click on the upload button instead, a model opens with a drag and drop area. But now we need some real data, so I'm going to show you how you can download free market data. I chose IC Trading as my broker, and I'm proud to say that I'm from now on affiliated with IC Trading. The complete project is free and open source on GitHub. Therefore, if you want to support this project and you are looking for a broker, check out IC Trading with the first link in the video description. You can start with a demo account, which is 100% free. And when you are ready, you can switch to a real money account and trade with super tight spreads and low commissions. When you have registered your account and you are logged in, you have the option to create different account types. For downloading data, you need to create a MetaTrader account. And here we can now see our newly created account. And you will also get an email with your login details. And if you follow this link, you can easily download the MetaTrader client. When you have downloaded the MetaTrader client, you now need to log in into your IC Trading account. You can do so by clicking on File and then on Login Trade Account. And here you need to input your login ID, which you find in your email and as well in the client area on IC Trading. And of course, the password and the server, which you also find in the client area. With clicking on OK, you will be logged in into your account. And then we can finally download the data. For doing this, we need to click on this yellow symbol with the dollar sign. And here a new window opens where we can select bars and then find the symbol we want to download data for. In the second dropdown, you can select the time frame. For me, I always choose the 1 minute time frame because I'm calculating the larger time frames based on this 1 minute candles. And then we just need to select a date range for the candles we want to download. With clicking on request, we get this preview with all the candles and the data. And when we now click on export bars, we can save the data as a CSV file. And this downloaded CSV file, I can now just drag and drop into the CSV upload. After doing so, the second tab, the preview and mapping, will be enabled. Here you can see which columns of the file are mapped to which columns of the database. There is automatic column detection and almost all the columns are also correctly identified. Only the volume column is detected twice. Since we are using a CFD broker, we don't have actual volume. So I'm using the tick volume and inserting this into the volume column and ignore the volume column by removing the mapping. And now I just need to click on upload data and all the data is automatically inserted into the database for the EURUSD symbol. This upload now takes a few minutes since we are inserting 2.1 million new candles into the database. And when the upload is ready, I can refresh the page and I'm seeing all the new data that was inserted. I can select different timeframes, for example, the daily timeframe. And here you can see the first candle is now from January 2020. I can also apply different indicators, but the calculation of them now takes a while, so there's still room for improvement and I need to optimize this. As you can see, it's now that easy to upload new data. I already have some ideas for improvements, but let me know in the comments what you think about the new update. If you are interested about a technical implementation, you can check out the GitHub repository and don't forget to check out IC Trading with the first link in the video description. See you in the next one.